Coming up, if you're looking to develop a strategy on what data to keep or delete inside of your organization, we're going to walk you through the data retention capabilities in Office 365 data governance with new updates, including the ability to retain your data in Microsoft Teams, event-based retention triggered by specific events, insights and analytics of your data using Labels Explorer, and managing your deletion process through disposition review. I'm joined today by Nishan Da Silva from the Data Governance team. Welcome.
Thanks for having me on the show.
So we're seeing a huge amount of interest in data retention, especially in light of things like GDPR and also the growing number of regulations in place globally. Now, the common wisdom might be to be able to keep your data as long as you possibly can, but that can be a true liability if you get hacked. Now, equally, not keeping the right data for whatever compliance reason might get you in trouble.
It can be. So what we advise everyone to do is to have a strategy around your overall data to reduce your risk. There's actually an industry principle of RUT analysis where you look at what's redundant, obsolete, and trivial.
Right. And this is one of the most important areas where tech can help you today. But how are we approaching this then in Office 365?
So traditional ways of doing that have typically required replicating your data and placing it into an external system. This can be costly and infinitely increase your risk because now you have your data in multiple places.
And ironically, that's replication or redundant, literally the R in RUT.
Absolutely. And our approach is to give you in-place retention and deletion in Office 365. Of course, if you have data stored on-premises or in other services, we help you bring the data into Office 365's data governance to take advantage of our built-in capabilities.
All right, so let's get into this. How do we actually determine what to keep or what to delete?
Depending on which industry you sit, there are different regulatory rules governing how long to keep specific types of data. Or you may need to set up retention policies that align to your business processes that show evidence of compliance. Ultimately, your compliance officer will know how long to retain your data to meet the relevant regulations.
And those rules actually need to be codified into your retention system, but how do you get started?
So our retention capabilities can be found in the Security and Compliance Center. And as a compliance officer, my experience is scoped only to the activities specific to my role.
Right, and this is something we regularly cover on Microsoft Mechanics, the Security Compliance Center. And for those of you who are new to it, it's really designed to be this cooperation between the compliance team on one hand and the IT team on the other. So you have a little bit of a different view than as an IT admin, different set of controls. In my case, I'm signed in here with the rights to assign permissions. So here in the Security and Compliance Center, I actually have the permissions tab open. I've created a data governance role. In this case, you can see the role name, the description that we've added to it, the different assignments of what you can do in terms of the capabilities that you'll need, and I've also assigned members there.
So now, as a compliance officer, I can do the things important to my role with tailored experiences.
So now again, just to point out, the IT team doesn't have to worry about anyone on the compliance side interfering with their policies or settings or IT configurations. But Nishan, why don't you actually show us what the compliance officer experience looks like?
Great. Consider the case of an international manufacturing company. We have data operations in EU, US, and a manufacturing plant in China. We have to abide and comply with a number of regulations globally.
And this is the case where you're going to need to balance all the regulations that you have in place, either where your offices are geographically located, for the markets where you want to do business in, and also where and how you manufacture.
Yes. And so here, let's go ahead and now go to data governance and into retention. We manufacture drones, and we have to comply with several regulations. As you can see here, I have created policies based on geographies and users. We have three different geographies with different retention regulations. And I also have an org-wide retention policy. Here, I'm going to create a new retention policy for the US operations for Microsoft Teams. Based on the regulation, we know that the longest required retention period is 15 years for my Asian policy for China, for devices and manufacturing. The default in the system is 7 years, but we can override that to the time period of 6 years, which is consistent with the other retention policy. And after that, retain the content based on either create or last modified. Mm-hmm. And we can also do what we want to do with the data when it gets deleted or not deleted. Here, I'll go ahead and say don't delete it, as we still want to have an internal review before we delete anything. I also have options for some advanced settings for auto classification, but for today, I'll keep going and click next. you'll see that we've added Microsoft Teams, and we'll continue to add more in time. I'll select Teams and Chats and hit Next and create that policy.
And the great thing here is I can also exclude certain groups from this policy, but what if I want to create a standard or default policy for my entire organization? Can I do that as well?
You can run an org-wide retention policy for any period of time. For here, you can see I have created an org-wide policy for 5 years across all workloads.
And the other thing is, if you have any policy conflicts, the retention policy is always going to win over a deletion policy. So we saw retention and geography and workload. Now we're actually including Microsoft Teams as something that we can select as a location or workload. And the users we also have selected to really help you when you have specific regulations that you're trying to adhere to when you're retaining your data. But what if you want to drive proactive retention related to an event or maybe a specific activity on a project, maybe the project's complete? How do we do that?
We know from industry data that more than 40% of retention categories are triggered by events. To make this easier, you can now do event-based retention in advanced data governance in Office 365. Here you'll notice on my left nav, I have a new sub-tab called Events. This is where you'll find and manage your event-based policies. Event-based retention works by first creating a label to classify specific information. So it's good to have a clear strategy on information classification in your organization with labeling of your data. For example, campaigns or specific launches that you may run as a business where you know there may be a need to manage the retention and deletion of that information within a specific period. Let's go ahead and create a label called Drone Oka Day 1 in regards to product launch. We'll set the retention as 5 years. I'm going to select, I want to trigger a disposal review because I want to make sure this content is reviewed prior to deletion at the end of the retention period. Here I have options from when to start a retention. It can be create date, last modified, labeled, or now event. I can select from three existing events that have broader scope, and I can talk a little bit more about that later, but I want to have an event trigger that is specific to this project. We'll give it a name, and we hit finish, and at this point, we can select that event and click add. And I'll go ahead and hit next and create this label. So now that after I created that label, now I can publish that label. I can now either publish to all locations, or I can select just to publish it to a single SharePoint site here by hitting Choose Sites. And I give it a name, and I'm done. Now I'm going to ask my SharePoint admin to apply the label Oka Drone Day 1 label as a default in SharePoint document library. It also retroactively apply to content uploaded. All they need to do is go to site settings and apply the label.
Now, how does the system actually know that the event has happened and occurred once the event gets triggered?
As the compliance officer, once I know the project is complete, I can go to the Events tab in Data Governance and create a new event called Drone Project Completion Retention Policy. And here, I have to choose the event type that we created earlier.
Okay.
And then I can figure out the day that project was closed. So here's the trigger. So we can pick today, or we can even go back and pick a previous date. And I create the event, and we're done.
Very cool. So you've shown us then a custom event, but what if you have a more common event that you actually want to automate that happens all the time?
Today, we supply PowerShell commandlets that allow to connect to other systems to trigger these events. And these are listed in the support documentation.
Right, so we just saw an event trigger, and the retention clock then is there to start retaining the data. And that's going to be based on the labels that you set. Now, labeling is central really to any retention strategy to make sure that the right things are kept or deleted. But how do you get insights in terms of how labels are being used in your organization?
Right. As you mentioned, any good data governance strategy starts with information classification. But to make this easier for you, we also quickly track which labels are in use in your organization and give you insights and analytics on specific trends.
But is there a way then that I can see how users are actually proactively labeling their content with specific labels?
Yes. If you click on our new Labels Explorer, you can drill down and take a look at Oka Day 1, and you can see that there has only been 15 labels applied to this. So here's where a scenario that we can think about is really to also take, this was manually labeled, we can also do auto classification. I can go ahead and create a new label and start doing an auto classification. And you can see that you can also auto apply to that label. Here we have two different ways of auto applying. So I can go ahead and type content contains specific words. So I can type the word drone, and it'll go ahead and look for any information regarding drone. I can give it a name of a policy, and I can then pick which location you want to do it. And because we want to look at wherever the word drone is located in our tenancy, I'm going to run it across everything in Office 365. So this way, that Labels Explorer now not only will capture the manual labeled, also the auto-applied label, so you have a 360 view of what you
see. So very cool. So this is all based on content search then directly from within Office 365.
That is correct.
What if I want to get rid of some unwanted data, personal data that I need to stop retaining? How can I do that?
We have three ways of delete data from Office 365. So let's go back to a label and create a new label, and let's give it a name, delete EU personal data for drone projects.
Okay.
And then I can go here and let's say the retention period here is 5 years. Mm-hmm. You can see there are three ways we can delete data from the system. One is delete the content automatically when it reaches the retention period. Mm-hmm. Second is trigger a disposal review or do nothing. In this case, let's go ahead and say we want to trigger a disposal review because we want to also make sure that someone is reviewing this data. In this case, we always give a best practice to not just pick an individual, actually to pick a group, because if an employee leaves the organization, you want to make sure that group is still alive. So here is where I'm going to pick the group called US Drone Compliance Group.
Sounds good. So given we had the option here to do automatic deletion, why would groups choose to do manual disposition review versus the auto delete?
This is if a business needs to either suspend or extend deletion or retention periods and make some high-value records that are in your organization that needs audited before they're permanently gone, it's always good to do a manual disposal. In data governance, I can see where these are pending dispositions. I can filter them by the different sources. So we have documents or emails. I can also source it by labels. I can also select a document that gives me the decisions of apply different label, extend it, or delete permanently. But I also can, which many organizations, data governance and compliance folks would do, is actually multi-select or bulk select and then go ahead and execute the disposition.
So you've gone through a full life cycle of information governance from retention-based policies on various inputs to insights, all the way down to deletion and disposition. But where can folks go to learn more?
Go to the link shown on the screen to learn more. We recommend your organization is using Office 365 E5 to take advantage of all these capabilities. And we'll be rolling out these new features to your organization soon.
And of course, keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates across Microsoft. That's all the time we have for today's show. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.